Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Sharon Oyella, and this is part 3 and the final part of our crochet eyeball eating monster. This is our prop for Halloween. If you've missed the previous parts, you can find those up in the iCard. You can also find more information in the description box below. Alright guys, let's get started. Now we're going to sew in our plastic piece into the head. We're going to stuff the head first, of course. And this plastic piece gets sewn just above the 14th row. So this last row here is number 15. We're going to sew it just above the 14th row. And you can lay your plastic, make sure it's all laid out like this. Lay your plastic over top and do your line. And you're just going to cut around that line. You don't cut outside the line because you want this to fit just inside. We don't want to spread this open. We want to keep this the same sort of width as the body. We made the body a little bit bigger because we sewed it lower in the fatter part of the belly. But this edge here and this edge here has the same number of stitches in it. So they should fit just right on top of each other, like so. Alright, so we're going to be stuffing this first and then sewing our plastic piece in. But for this one, like I said, I'm going to give you a different way of attaching this felt. So I'm going to use hot glue just on the inside. I'm not putting any hot glue on the outside because if I did, there is no way that I'd be able to get my needle through there. And I need to be able to get my needle through that last square. So around the center, and be careful because there is holes. You could burn yourself for sure. I've left the last two rows free of glue. And now this one, you have to be careful that you don't put your hands there. Actually, you know what I could do is lay this here and now squish this in. There we go. I'm just going to have felt on both sides. That's okay. That just kept me from burning myself. Yeah, that worked. And then I can place this in here. Okay, you don't have to worry about getting it all perfect here. Just you want to make sure that you're getting the part that you're going to start sewing to the 14th row. So this row right here. Now I'm going to carry this knot through the stitch post and not through a stitch hole. Make sure that my thread gets grabbed onto. Okay, and I go back in. And now I can't see my squares, so I'm just going to have to feel my way in there, coming through a square and through the felt at the same time. And then back over onto the 14th row. And don't worry too much if you have stitches that come down a little bit lower there, because we're not going to be able to see it anyway. So we don't have to be that neat. It's nice to keep things neat and tidy, but don't worry if you're thinking that the stitches are going to be seen, because they're not. Okay, I'm going to keep going all the way around. I made it all the way around and I totally forgot to stop and stuff more in. He's pretty well stuffed though. I could have stuck more in there before I closed it completely up. But so just keep that in mind before you sew all the way around. You want to leave a little bit of a gap, stuff what you can in there, and then you can finish sewing it up. I might find a little small gap somewhere and stick some stuffing in with a pencil maybe. Maybe I'll do it that way. Either way, I am done, so I'm going to knot off right here. And then I'll just carry this through and away and cut free. Let's see if I can find a spot that has a big enough gap in it where I can stick some stuffing in. Actually, I'm glad this happened because I can show you this part. So there's always different ways to get around things. We're never really stuck. And mistakes happen for a reason. What did Bob Ross say? There's no mistakes, just happy accidents. Alright, let's get this zipper sewn in place. Now remember at the beginning I told you there's two types of zippers. There's the one with the little stopper down here. Like the same kind of zippers that you find on a jacket. And you just pop that little straight edge back in there and then you can zip it back up. And then there's this type here that has a stopper built in, and there's no little flat edge there that will go back in once you take it all the way to the bottom. So this one is no problem. We can sew both in. It doesn't matter which one you use. This one is going to make your life a little bit easier because you can just sew the bottom piece in. And you don't have to worry about this one being sewn to this one while holding on to the bottom. You see what I'm saying? So if you have one of these, that's wonderful. If you don't, it's still going to work. So I've already trimmed my black one here. If I was going to be using this white one, what I want to do is unzip it, because we're going to be trimming it off here. And we want the zipper to be on the other end before we trim. Okay, and if you take a look at my original guy, his arms are on either side of that zipper, but these arms get sewn in after we put the monster together. So if you take a look, there's the tail. The arms are going to go on either side. So I'm just going to guess. So I'm just going to do my best job here of figuring out where it starts and stops. And it's going to be right here. So I'm going to trim. And I'm going to trim the top to match. Alright guys, in the next clip I've sewed this zipper in on film for you, but I was thinking about it after. The way I told you to measure the zipper, you don't have to be exact. You can actually carry the zipper all the way around. It can go the entire width of your monster, like, or not the width, but all around the inside, the monster, and that would work too. And then the whole head would be a zipper that you could take off, potentially. The only thing I was thinking about was these arms. This one here, the zipper is just his mouth, and I wasn't thinking about taking his whole head off, but you could do it that way if you wanted to design it that way yourself. These arms are going to be sewn in. I wanted them pretty much in line with the mouth there, but you can sew them underneath for sure, and they would be sewn underneath the zipper, so you could keep that zipper going all the way around. So it's up to you how you do it. I'm going to keep it like this, where his mouth is all that I use for the zipper part. So what we want to do before we get started, guys, and you don't have to do this part, but I think it's safer to do this. Add a little stopper here at the end that will keep your zipper from being able to be pulled all the way out, because I did that when I was sewing one of my monsters together. I actually pulled the zipper right off the wrong end, and I had a heck of a time getting it back in place. Oh, I had a really hard time, and I thought, oh, I wrecked everything, so I'll have to cut the zipper out, but I didn't have to. I did finally get it back, but it was a problem. Okay, I'll just see if that will stop it from being pulled, and it does add a little bit of a stop there. If I pulled hard enough, it would still rip right off of there, but it will give me a second to say, oops, I'm going the wrong direction here. Okay, and I'm just going to knot off. I'll just leave the thread attached, and I'll bring it down and get it ready and in position to be sewn. Okay, now I'm ready to sew this on. Like I said, if you have one of these zippers that has a thing that you can stick back on, you can just take them apart now and sew one piece in at a time, and your life is so much easier. But I'm going to do it this way so you can see how it's done without being able to take it apart. There we go. Okay, and now, like I said, we want to go right in the middle here. Now, when you're sewing it in, you want to make sure that the zipper part stays above that last edge of the crochet, always. Okay, you want to make sure it's clearing that top. So you're going to be sewing just the fabric part in. Make sure the zipper is always above. Okay, I'm just going to start sewing it in. I'm doing a stitch on the top and then on the bottom. So I'm sewing the bottom part of the zipper down as well. Otherwise it'll stick up, which is fine. But I'm just doing two stitches, one on the top and one on the bottom. There, I'm putting one at the bottom. I'm just going to make the zipper more sturdier as well. Oh, this gets caught on everything. Gotta take your time. On my original guy, I gave him a tongue that can be pulled out here. and it's pretty long. You can decide, do you want one or not? It's totally up to you. If you wanted one, you could sew it in. How could we do this? We could hot glue it in as well. Maybe I'll just hot glue one in. You want to make sure that it's long enough where it's going to come out, of course, and you can reach in there and grab it. Like I said, this is optional. You don't have to do this part at all. There's no law that says it has to have a tongue. So I just put a little line there, and I don't want it touching anything else except for where exactly where I want it. So I'll just pop it into place there. Right at the very bottom. And now I can just fold it back and it'd be out of my way. Now we're going to sew the top piece in, and you'll notice when you stick it on there, this part here will most likely be too wide and it's going to interfere. So we're just going to trim a little bit of that down. Not too much, because you still need some fabric there to be able to sew. So I've closed my zipper, you can see, and I'm just going to take about, I don't know how much that is, just a little bit. An even amount right across. And there, it still has enough there to be sewn into place. And now I'm just going to push this down. I'm pulling my yarn out away from that area, kind of give me some stuff to work with there. Okay, just bring your needle through and thread it through a couple times on that fabric, just to get it started. And then bring your piece in. Now this part's very important. When you start, you want to make sure that your head and your face, or your face part, is in line with the tail. You don't want that off too far. There we go. And now my needle is ready to go. So I'm just going to pop in a couple stitches here. And then I can unzip it all. Oh, I should have brought this to the... There. I'll bring the thread on this side and I'll do that again. It'll be a lot easier. And do take your time to make sure everything is lining up. Otherwise, you're going to be disappointed. And you might have to undo it all if you sew it in all wonky. So you want that nose in line with the tail. Okay, and now we're ready to start sewing. I'm going to get my first stitch in. It's going to make this so much easier. And I'll just bring that through. Okay, I'm going to unzip this now. I got my first stitch in there. So just leave this part on the table. You got your first stitches in there, you know exactly where it's supposed to be. Then you can just readjust, pull that thread so it's tight. And after you get a few stitches, then it's going to get even easier. And remember what I said about having the zipper always visible above that crocheted edge. So we're just going to get a few stitches back and forth here. I think that'll do it. There we go. Now I can continue sewing around. If you can sew it sitting at a table, it'll be so much easier for yourself. You can just lay everything on the table and just hold that in place and then sew across. And it gets a little bit awkward here. Just be careful with that needle. I've already stabbed myself like 3 times. So this is the part. If your zipper comes apart, you can take it apart. It'd be so much easier for you guys. If it doesn't, then you'd have to continue sewing and just holding it as I'm doing here. But if you can take it apart, look how much easier that is. And I've made it to the end, so I'm just going to knot off. And then I'll just pull it down and through and cut it free. Alright, now we can sew the back of him together, and that's very simple. All we're going to do is just whip stitch this edge to this edge, and I'm just going to wrap the yarn around, And I'm going to show you what to do with the zipper parts once we get this breast sewed up here. So that's all there is to this part, just going in the stitch and then like so. Okay, so you can see right here, when I open the zipper, it only goes so far anyway. So what I can do is just close it up to where it stops, where the zipper stops. So just go in and through the stitch right on top and pull tight and to the next one. And before I pull that tight, I'm just going to go through that loop, because I want to knot it off at the same time. And there we go. Okay, now that part is done. Now I need to get this part sewn together. So I'll just bring the yarn tail inside and come out through a stitch hole here. So I'm not going to pull tight because it'll suck that in. And now I can sew this side closed the same way I did the first side. Okay, so I'm right at where the zippers end there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to close the zipper and see as far as I want it to go. Probably right there. So you see the inside zippers here. I'm going to tuck one behind the other. I'll do the top one behind the bottom one. Just going to tuck them like that. And now I'm going to sew the same way I was doing the previous stitches, one stitch to the next, and pull tight, and then the next one, and pull tight, and the next one. And I'll stop and see if that's where I want it to. I think it looks good right about there. I'll do one more, and then I'll knot off. Okay, so now I can just bring this up anywhere to the back of the head. And I'm going to knot it off again so it doesn't pull through. And if you don't think it knotted off, do it again. Go through that loop and pull tight. Now I can just bring it through and cut free. Oh my goodness. Okay. I don't know why that just struck my funny cord, but it did. Her funny bone. Alright, now we can sew the arms in, and this is very simple as well, guys. It's just a matter of whip stitching them into place. So remember when we did the thumbs, they'll be right and left. And they get sewn right in line with the ears. And I'll put it right here. And I'm going to whip stitch it to that seam that we just made. Going through that seam and then through the top stitches of the arm. And pull. And I'm just going to add a stitch a little bit lower there, just to tuck the arm in. Okay, I'm going to do one on the back here as well. So I'll just carry this through and come on the side. And then tack this little spot down. And I'll come out anywhere and pull and see how that looks. And that looks good. So now I just have to knot off. So on the other arm you saw me wrapping from the top and through and then through the arm immediately. Give yourself a break. You can just bring it through. If you have a hard time doing it that way, just bring it through the top seam. Now that you have it there, now you can just bring it through the top of the arm. See that top stitch. And that way there's no struggle and you still get the stitch in there. and that just eliminates some stress. So I'll do that again. This is the last one. I'll bring it through. And now I'll wrap it over the arm. And I'm going to bring it to the back side. And tack it over this one. And I'll bring the yarn tail out and anywhere it feels comfortable. And the arm looks good. So I'll just knot off and carry it away and break free. You should be able to just put your monster down and he should just stand up on his own. If he's not doing that, if he's flopping over, that means the tail is just sitting too low. So you can just bend it up. So every time that you stick him down, he should just stand up really good on his own. So I've decided I want to give this guy a little bit more fur on top or hair on top. So I just made a small bundle. And I'm going to pull them through the exact same way I showed you how to do earlier using my crochet hook. And I'm just going to go around. I don't know how many rows I'm going to do. I'm just going to go by looks. So I'll just start anywhere here and I'll just go around and around until I feel it's full enough. And then I'll split them all. And then we'll come back and see what we got. So this is the before. And I think he looks a little bit cuter, if you can call it that, with that little extra bit of hair. Alright, so now if you wanted to add the spots on the back, you would just simply grab a strand of the color of your choice. I'm going to use orange. And you can go in anywhere. You can start anywhere you want to. I'll just bring it through and come up right here. I'm going to wrap around. I'm going to knot off the first time I go around. This is the only time I have to knot off working with this strand of yarn. So I'll knot there. And I'll just wrap another time or two. There's one and two. I'm going to cut this other one free so I'm not stuck to that ball of yarn. And I'll just hold it out of my way. And now I'll just go back in one more time, and I can come over here. So you can make these even, like this one is kind of like even spots that I put in, or you can just do them random. It's totally up to you guys how you want to do this. And I'll pull it over, and then I'll wrap here. One, two, and three. And now I'll bring it in, and I'll go over couple of stitch holes, and I'll put another one right here. Okay, I decided to bring those spots right down the tail. And again, this is all optional. So when your yarn tail gets too short to work with, just bring it through and then knot it off. Once it's knotted off, you can just carry it out anywhere and then cut it free. And now you can just take the other yarn tail and do the same thing. Do the stop spots, and when you're done, just knot it off and break free. And you'll be using a couple of different strands, I'm sure. You can make one really super long strand, but it just gets a little bit difficult to work with. So I find just adding in a couple of strands, doing one shorter one at a time, is a little bit easier to manage. So you can see I ended up adding them to the front, and I wasn't planning that when I started. And I also made them bigger than the ones in the back. All I did was just wrap it more times. Okay, so that ends that part of the tutorial. We're done. Coming up in the next couple of days, it's not ready at the time of this filming. Today is, well, for you it'll be October 1st. For me it's September 30th, 2019, and I haven't gotten the eyeballs on video yet, but they are on my blog, so you can pick up the written patterns for that. So there's two sizes, there's the large and the small. So the bigger one is more for like a decoration. You can hang them around the house at Halloween, stick them in a jar or on a platter, whatever you want to do. The smaller one is for this guy here, for Gurgle. He likes to eat eyeballs, and that was the whole plan when I first came out with this pattern, was an eyeball eating monster. The bigger one will fit too, but you have to squish it quite a bit. Alright guys, that will end this part of the video tutorial. I hope you found this helpful, and if you did, please give the video a thumbs up. That really helps me out a lot, and I appreciate every single one I get. And until next time, I hope you enjoyed this video, and happy Halloween, everyone. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you super soon.